Good morning everyone, welcome to my channel Theoretical Agri Study. A part of this, our first book is Principles of Genetics by Dr. Fundan Singh, which is important for all the agri related examinations. So let's get started with our first topic. So our first topic is Mendel's laws of inheritance. Of this, first let us go with the introduction. So Mendel's laws of inheritance, it is essential to define genetics. So first, what is genetics? So genetics is defined as the branch of biology which is concerned with the study of heredity and variation in living organisms. So what does that mean? So what is genetics? It is a branch of the biology. It is genetics is not an applied science. It is a branch of the biology. It is concerned with the study of the heredity. What is heredity? That means the transfer of the characters from our ancestors to our daughters and from us to our granddaughters and their granddaughters. It is called as genetics. So in other words, genetics is a scientific study of principles of heredity and variation in living organisms. Next, heredity. What is heredity? So heredity refers to the transmission of traits from parents to their offsprings, and the variation refers to resemblances and differences of heritable characteristics among individuals of a species. So a general question is, who is the father of modern genetics? So Gregor John Mendel is the father of modern genetics. So he has two principles, law of segregation and law of independent assortment. So here it is. So hence his principles of heredity are law of segregation and law of independent assortment, which are now universally accepted. For this outstanding contribution, Mendel is known as the father of modern genetics. So in this introduction, the important points are what is genetics and who is the father of modern genetics, and in which year Gregor John Mendel has published his paper. So Mendel's experiments. So what are the Mendel's experiments? They are various aspects of Mendel investigations. So that is selection of crop, selection of traits, adoption of methodology, publication of results derived, reaction on Mendel's results, and rediscovery of Mendel's results. These are briefly discussed as follows. So what are the various aspects of Mendel's investigations? For first one is selection of the crop. So the type of crop which he had been selected. Selection of traits. So what are the traits? Traits in otherwise it is called as characters. Characters Mendel had been selected are plant, stature, position of the flower, shape of the pod, color of the pod, seed shape, seed color, seed coat color. See, here is a question, that is how many plants of pea Mendel had been selected. Is the answer is 21. So this is a very important question. So what, how many characters Mendel had selected? The answer is 7. What are the, how many plants did Mendel selected? 21 pea plants. So this is a basic question and this is a very important question. So next, what is the methodology adopted? So Mendel has maintained the genetic purity of the material. So what is the methodology? He had selfed all the plants with of an individual character. So every individual character he had selfing, he had done selfing, and proper records of the material had been maintained. Next, publication of the Mendel's results. So he has published his results in his newspaper, in his paper, that is Experiments on Plant Hybridization, in the year 1865. So this is a very important question. Next, reaction on Mendel's results. So so generally, if a new work had been introduced, so many of the people will reject it. So as that same, as the same procedure, the Mendel's book was also been rejected. Next, rediscovery of Mendel's results. So when the Mendel has been passed away, then in the 1900 year, Hugo de Vries and along with his mates, he rediscovered the Mendel's results. So what are the Mendel's laws of inheritance? First one is law of segregation, and the second one is law of independent assortment. So what is law of segregation? So in this, so let us see the example. Capital P cross small p. What is this? Of this, these are the characters. P purple flower and white flower. Let us consider the purple flower as a male one. Oh, sorry, it is the female one and the white flower as the male one. So, now let us see. Capital P, cross small p. So, what do we get is small p. So, of this the gamete is capital P and of this the gamete is small p. So, now this is our F1 generation. So, what we do for the F1 generation is we will self it. So, we will just self it. So, what do we get is, so draw a checkerboard. This is capital P, small p. Capital P, small p. We'll get capital P, capital P, capital P, small p, capital P, small p, small p, small p. So, what did we get from this is, this is 1, these are same 2 and this is 1. So, what is the ratio did we get from this is 1 is to 2 is to 1. That is 1 homozygous, 2 heterozygous and 1 homozygous. This is dominant, capital P, and this is recessive. This is 2 is the heterozygous, capital P and small p. And this is all about your law of segregation. And in the law of segregation, we have to remember the phenotypic ratio and the genotypic ratio. The phenotypic ratio is 3 is to 1. That is, even it is heterozygous, the dominant one will be overcome the recessive one. So, 3 purple and 1 white color. And in the genotypic ratio, it is 1 is to 2 is to 1. And now, let us go to law of independent assortment. In law of independent assortment, the parents we have selected are yellow round seed and green wrinkle seed. The genotypes are capital Y, capital Y, capital R, capital R. Green wrinkle seed has the genotype small y, capital R, capital R. This is a double. So, now, here is the example. Capital Y, capital R, small y, small r. So, the genotypes are capital R, capital Y, small r are the genotypes. So, now, let us see the example here. So, what is the example we have got is capital Y, capital R cross, small y, small r. So, what are the genomes we get? That is gametes. Capital Y, capital R, small y, small r. So, these are the gametes we have got in our F1 generation. So, this is F1 generation. Next, capital Y, capital R, cross, small y, small r. So, what we get is capital Y, capital R, small r. So, this is our product. We have got this. So, we have to do is cross. This is our F1 generation and we have to cross this with the same, which is called as selfing. So, what should we do is capital R, small r cross, capital R, small r. So, do a checkerboard, capital Y, small r, small y, capital R and capital Y, small r. Do this. Now, what do we get? Same. Capital Y, capital R, capital Y, capital R, small r. So, like this, we have to do the checkerboard and so that we get the ratio of 9 is to 3 is to 3 is to 1. So, this is our phenotypic ratio. So, this is our phenotypic ratio. And what will be the genotypic ratio for dihybrid cross? For dihybrid cross, what is our ratio? Comment below the answer. So, and this is about your Mendel's laws of inheritance, that is law of segregation and law of independent assortment. And I am sharing you this PDF in the link description. So please do follow this channel. And remember, these are the questions which are important for your further studies. So please do solve all these questions and comment below the answers. Thank you. Thank you for watching.